The map on the screen is the R1a frequency in the region where the Y-DNA haplogroups R1a-L664 are observed. R1a-L664 are northwestern Europeans, mainly found in western Germany, Low Countries, and the British Isles. Let's look at the proportion of R1a-L664 among Europeans with R1a in these regions. Within R1a, L664 has a relatively high frequency in Isles and Low Countries, where R1a is sparse. L664 is found mainly in the Baltic and North Seas and throughout the islands, especially in counties south of England. It appears to be a coincidence that L664 existed throughout the North Sea horizons of Bronze Age merchants. This is because most of the cases on the island are relatively recent. If so, when and where did they migrate to this area? Please stay tuned. R1a-L664 is thought to have formed sometime south of the Carpathian Mountains in Central Europe around 4,600 years ago, or about 2,600 BCE. The time to most recent common ancestor, TMRCA, is 3,900 years ago, or about 1,900 BCE. The year of formation and TMRCA are on the screen at the bottom of the circle with the SNP marker. Their ancestors are estimated to have lived in the steppe east of the Ural Mountains between 22,800 and 18,200 years ago. Some of the descendants of this R1a-M420 migrate southwest for a long time, giving birth to the L664. Please refer to the video linked in the upper right corner for the diffusion process of R1a-M420. Branches of L664 have moved north to the Low Countries, the British Isles, and Scandinavia. On the screen, the number on the left of slash indicates the frequency of R1a, and the number on the right shows the ratio of L664 among R1a. L664 is a very mysterious SNP of R1a. Most of the branches of R1a migrated to the Bronze Age, which is associated with the corded ware culture, but the L664 moved elsewhere much later than that time. Please see the video linked in the upper right corner for the diffusion process of R1a-Z283, the main branch of R1a. Between about 500 BCE and 1500 BCE, they migrated to the lowlands, the British Isles, and Scandinavia. Branches that contributed to this proliferation include S2858, S2880, YP282, S3477, and YP54527. Let's plot their estimated travel routes on a map. One branch of R1a-L664 is moving towards the North Sea. They belong to S2858 and YP9431. Groups belonging to the R1a-S2858 branch appear to have been migrating between 1000 BC and 500 AD, or about 1,500 years. The YP943 branch was born later. One of the essential branches of R1a-L664 is S2894. The branch of S2857 migrated in the North Sea direction, while the branches belonging to S2894 migrated in both Scandinavia and the North Sea directions. The branches that migrated only to Scandinavia are S2880 and YP432. Among the sub-branches of S2894, some of those belonging to YP285 migrated to Scandinavia. Another group migrates to the North Sea. The SNPs of the group that migrated to the North Sea are those with YP282. Migration of populations belonging to YP441 is associated with Germanic expansion. Then, we will look at their estimated migration route through the map. People belonging to R1a-L664 moving in the North Sea direction gave birth to R1a-S2894 in Central Europe around 2210 BC. They migrated west again, and around 1880 BC, people with S2880 were formed. Some of these migrated towards Denmark, and YP432 was formed at about 1650 BC. By YP432 was formed, another group belonging to S2984 migrated to the North Sea, resulting in YP285 around 1530 BC. At about 980 BC, a group belonging to S2880 crossed the sea and arrived in Scandinavia, where S2886 was born. YP431, a branch of YP432, was also born in Scandinavia around 630 BC. YP285's branch has moved in two directions. Around 230 BC, one group migrated to present-day Sweden, and the other group, YP441, is estimated to have migrated to the lowland countries around 190 BC. YP1014 belonging to YP441 moved across the sea to England. Around 94 BC, the YP1014, YP1015, YP4123, YP4515, YP4535, and YP5084 were all born around the same time. These appear to be related to the spread of the Vikings. S2889 and YP444 spread into Scandinavia around 110 AD and 640 AD. Then, this time, we will see the diffusion process of S3479, the main branch of L664. S3479, or CTS1733, was born around 2350 BC. Their sub-branches spread to Belgium, Britain, Ireland, Poland, and Czechia. And YP5527, another direct branch of L664, was born around 1660 BC and spread to Low Countries and Alsace. Let's see how they spread through the map. S3479 was born around 2350 BC in Central Europe, and YP5527 migrated to Low Countries around 1660 BC. A sub-branch of S3479 and S3447 appeared in England around 1150 BC. Some of these sub-branches appear to have returned to Low Countries after 180 AD. Another branch moved further west and spread into Ireland around 950 AD. So far, we have introduced the diffusion process of Y-DNA haplogroup R1a-L664. In the following video, we will introduce the spread of R1a ancestor Z93 to Asia. Please give thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications.